Welcome back. We've got more hot topics to cover before we go. Panelists Anamari, Dawn, and Luli return. What about holidays? Are we going to travel to see your relatives? How safe do you feel on planes?
I usually travel a lot, but I haven't been on a flight for quite a few months. So it's a really big lifestyle change. I actually look forward to traveling again. I think we're going to try to go somewhere for Thanksgiving this year. I believe in wearing masks at all times when I'm out in public. I have it all prepared for my trip. I have different types of masks, different layers.
I would normally go back to Iowa for Christmas, and I was just talking to myself, which you do when you live by yourself during COVID, talking to myself about maybe I'll get a refundable ticket for Christmas and then see how I feel. Because it was a big decision to travel to the Wubble to see the finals for the Storm. It was not an easy decision to do that. And you just feel like, okay, you got to pick your risks. And that was one that I really wanted to be there, but I might skip Christmas in Iowa this year because I just not feeling comfortable with it.
Well, you know, I was on a call with some folks from Alaska, and I think that they are doing a tremendously good job on planes. And so, you know, I'm not particularly concerned about being on a plane, but, you know, and I'm really hungry to see, you know, my nieces and nephews and their little ones. But the hard thing is that the little ones aren't going to be quarantining. And, right. And I do have some autoimmune issues. And so, you know, I'm a little bit on the edge. So, I have a place on San Juan Island, and we'll probably have some friends up over the Christmas holidays. But I really miss the little ones, but I don't think it's time yet.
Yeah, it is good to stay safe and take precautions, I think, at this point. And really quickly, last question I have for you. Favorite hobby during COVID? Anamari?
Hiking and walking. We have such a beautiful campus, and you know, we have wonderful spaces near the water and the big trees, and that has been my saving grace, has been, you know, walking, hiking. Nature reminds you that the world, you know, us humans are having a hard time, but you know, the world is there, and we will survive.
I have a large deck. I live in a condo, but I have a large deck, and so I have a fairly extensive potted garden there, and that was really a lifesaver for me, just to be able to, the same thing, Anamari, that you're touching nature, you're somehow involved with things still growing and blooming and giving you pleasure at a time when it's really hard, when it's really gloomy. Playing with my cats, I have two cats, and we've bonded even more closely.
So through the whole spring and summer, it was picnic every weekend. So we loved picnic before, but now we're in love with it. Now that it's cooler, I think we're going to do it in the living room floor because it's cold outside, but we did so many picnics outdoors. It was beautiful.
That's a great idea. Take it indoors. And I've got to say, I love, also, we used to take drives. We would just drive during COVID. I wouldn't even get out of the car. We might get out and stretch and get back in the car and drive to different areas of Puget Sound that were just beautiful, right? But I do have to also say, reality shows, a little bit of escape. So I kind of did get into that with my daughters and my family. Thanks again to our fabulous Hot Topic panelists for joining us. And thank you for spending time with us today too. Stick around for King 5 News at noon, and we'll see you right back here tomorrow at 11:00.